Engineering videos and technical solutions, BTEC and Master Engineering thesis guidance, simulation of projects using different software such as MATLAB, PVSys, Helioscope, ETAP, and many more. Detailed videos on these topics and much more available software such as AutoCAD, Revit, and SketchUp. Be part of our family by subscribing to our YouTube channel, follow us on Instagram, like our Facebook page, and visit our website. PZ Engineering, passion to excel.
Hi, welcome to the PZ Engineering channel. In this video, we are going to show how to design and implement of an MPPT based solar charge controller in MATLAB Simulink software. Before we start with our simulation, I would like to request, if you are not yet part of our family, please subscribe to the channel, share our content, comment and like this video. This is our system. I'll just go through each component. We can get all the components from library browser. Here we have our PV array. These are the parameters. Here we have our blocking diode, generating, and here we have our capacitor. This is the value of our capacitor. This is the our MOSFET didn't change anything. Here I have another diode, didn't change anything. Here I have our inductor. This is the value, 10 to the power minus 3. Here I have our capacitor 2. That's the value. And here we have our battery, lead acid 48, 200 capacity, 50, and then battery response 30. Here it goes to, the signal goes to the MPP solar charge controller to charge the battery. That's the battery parameters. If you go there, we can check from here. Prepare to observe algorithm. Is to the power, PV power. Here we have our delay, unit delay, minus the reference, that's the reference, we give the reference power, and then it goes to the switching, or to the switch. You can just follow everything there. Here we have our voltage, and our voltage reference. Our voltage that goes to the unit delay, that should give us our voltage, our reference voltage, and goes to the switch. As you can follow everything there. This one memory with the battery, and then our limit from 0.6 to 0.4 output power. Here we have our battery parameters. Here we have our state of charge. This is like it's minus 100. Here we have our current, and there we have our voltage, battery voltage, and there is our battery power, and then you have our reference. You can just follow as is there. Our mean, gain, and PW generator, depends on the value that you are using. It's our PWM, which is connected to the MOSFET. Here is our measurement. just change our simulation time. Now we can I think everything's okay. We can run. As you can see, just the power output of our PV array, that's the same. And here we have our state of charge of the battery, which is now is charging, was 50, now is going up. Let's just open our graph. You say the state of charge is going up, means it's charging. Let's see our current. The current is negative, and here is our voltage. Let's play around our solar radiation. Let's increase our solar radiation. And the output solar should increase as well. Yeah, as you can see, it increased. Well, let's keep on increasing. Or playing around, it will reduce. Thank you so much for watching. Please be part of our family by subscribing to our channel. Share our contents, comment, and like our video.